for about 5 to 7 minutes, we meet Ray Ball. Thank you very much. Garrett, Gus Glenor, team players, please line up. Before we begin, I'd like to say thank you to Costa Papa Di Matteo, a HAPA, and the Carlos brothers here for setting this up and making this a wonderful event. A little over a year ago, a dear friend of ours, Albert Franks, passed away. Albert was from Las Vegas. He was one of the most vibrant, competitive, generous, compassionate, loving, and genuine human beings I ever met. He was a successful real estate businessman. He organized all of the tournaments here in the 90s. I don't know how old he was, I don't know how old. He was a devout supporter of Yehapa and the beautiful church they have here in Las Vegas. Right now, we honor his memory with the Albert Flagus MVP Award. Not the most valuable player, but the most valuable person. Because Al was that type of guy. He loved playing basketball. He wasn't always the MVP, but he was the most valuable person at the tournaments. So today, right here, this moment, we present this honor in his name. I want you to listen to the recipient of this honor. At age 17, he joined the U.S. Navy and went to Japan and was part of the initial occupation in Tokyo in 1945. He then joined Reynolds Electric Company and led the initial efforts to move atmospheric nuclear weapons testing program underground. He was at the Nevada test site for 37 years and became the tunnel superintendent. They built over 47 miles of underground tunnels. There, he served as an underground expert on the treaty monitoring teams for the Threshold Test Ban Treaty and Peaceful Nuclear Explosions Treaty, traveling to Russia in capacity on the U.S. teams. He then ran for lieutenant governor in 1966. In the 60s and 70s, he became the individual who took it upon himself to build all the lights at almost all the existing baseball fields here in Las Vegas. There's a huge park right here by the airport called Sunset Park. Me and the guys went there 2 days ago. This individual built all those lights at that park. In 1975, he built the most beautiful $3 million facility with 4 basketball courts, 6 racquetball courts, and after 1984, sold it to the city of Las Vegas for $1. It should have been made there. He was also on the board of public works here, UNLV Athletic Commission, board of directors for Boys and Girls Club of Las Vegas, and a trustee for the University Medical Center Foundation, and a Nevada Engineer of the Year in 1976, honored in 1984 as Distinguished Nevada by the University of Board of Regents, and then received the Award of Excellence in Support of Nuclear Weapons Testing Program in 1992. He has been an active member of the St. John Baptist Church here in Las Vegas for over 50 years, with so much philanthropy I can't tell you. Who else would receive this honor but Albert and his father, William Bill Flagus.
Congratulations.